Throughout the U.S. and around the world, education is shifting toward 21st century knowledge and skills that prepare students to compete in a global economy. Most students today have the world at their fingertips, seamlessly connecting with their friends via texting, playing games with their peers halfway around the world on their computers, and accessing real-time information on their tablets. However, many of their classrooms still look, feel, and sound much the same way they did when their grandparents were in school.
Teachers get frustrated all the time, and I hear them say, you know, kids come in, they should sit down, they should pay attention, they should listen to me. Just because I'm standing up here and I'm an adult and they're a teenager, but times are different. Those things still apply, but the world it looks different today than it did 40 years ago. And we have to adjust to that. And if it means that we have to find a way to meaningfully adapt our curriculum to meet their interests, then that's what we need to do.
The idea behind personalized learning is simple. Each student is unique. Each student has different needs, preferences, and abilities, and each student learns different topics at different paces. Personalized learning is about supporting each and every student by rethinking the way we teach our students. It's about being creative in how we use our time and resources. Right now, Delaware districts and schools and schools across the country and around the world are using new and innovative methods to engage students and maximize learning. If Delaware is going to provide world-class education to every student, we need to grow this innovation so learning is a truly personal experience for every teacher and every student in the first state. To do that, we must rethink the time, pace, place, and approach of how we educate our students. Advances in technology provide many exciting opportunities for educators to personalize learning for their students. iPads, computer and online programs, and social media are just some of the tools that teachers can use to help students learn at their own pace and be able to seamlessly continue their work in a different place and time, like in the library or at home in the evening.
She's going online at night looking at videos on multiplication, long division, how to process those things. So her teacher is right there even when she's home to help her go through those things.
Here, the teacher is using a wiki with her students. A wiki is a website that allows students to create and manage instructional content in a collaborative way. Students upload their work to the website, collaborate with their peers, and even make videos and digital journal entries through their wiki site. However, this approach is about more than technology. It is about using technology to change the way students interact with both their peers and their teacher, opening up classrooms to new instructional approaches and rich content that helps them progress faster and go further than previously possible.
Another way that I incorporate technology is I have started using this year the flipped classroom model for math instruction. And what that does is instead of where I would typically be in front of the class demonstrating, lecturing to the students, I deliver my instruction over a YouTube video. And the students watch the YouTube video at home, and then they do the practice in class. And that allows me to meet their individual needs, walk around, see how they are solving the problems. If I need to intervene, I can intervene quicker than if they were doing the practice problems at home.
This is a hugely effective way to enable students to progress faster or spend more time on a topic, depending on their needs.
When I'm using this personalized learning approach, it doesn't matter what level the student is on, I can target their specific needs and help them catch up quicker than I would be able to if we were all doing the same assignment and working on the same thing and then just going over it as a class.
There are 25 students in this class. Imagine getting 25 different papers and handwriting comments for the entire document. When it's online, I can quickly access it from home. I can drop in looking at those key criteria, and I can make comments quickly. Within about an hour, I can accomplish 25 papers. That's revolutionary.
Personalized learning builds on much of what we're already doing through the state's Race to the Top plan. Personalized learning offers a new vision for education, one in which students become the center of the learning environment, using technology to support a more individualized learning experience, both inside and outside the classroom.
It helps me for college, to get college and career ready.
the time is right. We have the power to turn education in Delaware into a student-centered, uniquely personal learning environment. We know this is just the beginning, and we have a long way to go. What we need now is to expand upon and grow the innovation in these classrooms and spread them throughout the state, making personalized learning a tangible goal for all students and all teachers. Because every student is different, and because every student deserves to have their education focused on their specific needs, abilities, and dreams for the future.